everybody, and welcome. This is the anime tag. This is five questions, everything to do about anime, and let's have them. First question, guys. What is your favorite anime movie? And for this question, thought about it for a little while. I'm going to have to go with 1993's Ninja Scroll, guys. This was directed, written by Yoshiaki Kawajiri. And he's the same guy who did Wicked City and Vampire Hunter D, Bloodlust. I don't know why I went a little country there, but it did. And basically the premise of this is a gang of demon killers. They're off to overthrow the Shogun. And a wandering swordsman teams up with a ninja girl. And she's got poisonous skin. And all these demons are crazy, have powers and stuff. And, like, you know, it's a cool movie. It's definitely a cool movie. It's got Koichi Yamadera, who was Tagusa in Ghost in the Shell 1 and 2. And for you Dragon Ball Super fans, he was also Beerus. So it's kind of cool. Lord Beerus, the Destroyer. How about that? Also stars Emi Shinohara, who was the voice of Sailor Jupiter on Sailor Moon, which, you know, it's pretty cool. She was also Bakaruyu Pitra in Bakaruyu Abaranger. Or Bakaruya Sentai Abaranger, excuse me. Can't forget the Sentai, guys. You know how I feel about Super Sentai, so that's obviously special for me. I recommend seeing it. It's just all around a decent anime movie. I wouldn't kick it out of bed for eating crackers. That's for sure. Second question, guys. Favorite anime series? I'm not the biggest anime fan, but I do like anime, and there's most of the ones I like are not movies, but in fact TV series. So I thought about it long and hard, and I came up with all around, all bases covered on this one. I came up with Cowboy Bebop. You know, created by created by Hajime Yate, who did Big O and Mobile Suit Gundam, guys. So it's kind of cool. It's basically, it follows the story of a bunch of bounty hunters, and they're in space, they're hunting criminals for money. You know, you've got sort of this guy with a checkered past, Spike Spiegel, who's voiced by Koichi Yamadera, who was the narrator in Godzilla Final Wars. That's kind of neat. You got another character, Jet Black. He's kind of like a former police officer. He's got a metal arm. You got Faye Valentine. She's sort of this girl out of time. There's a whole story behind that. I don't really want to go into it if you haven't seen Cowboy Bebop, but you really should watch it. It's a great show. Of course, she was voiced by Megumi Hashibara, who was the female voice in Ranma One Half, which is kind of cool. She also was Himeko Nayataka. Excuse me. Himeko Nayataki. Can't pronounce things today, guys. Sorry about that. Nah, that was in Sailor Moon, the movie. Sailor Moon S, the movie. Hearts of Ice. So check out Cowboy Bebop, guys. You really should. Don't just, you know, believe the hype on that one. Just do it. Next question. Favorite anime character? That one was much easier. I picked Aika from 2010's Squid Girl, which was created by Masahiro Anbe. And the basic premise of this is there's sort of this, there's a squid girl, okay, guys? She lives underneath the sea, and she gets kind of upset at mankind for all their trash in the sea and just basically making her place to live kind of shitty. So she decides that she's going to invade the Earth and teach mankind a lesson. So she pops up on the shore. First place she encounters is this fun little ramen bar, the Lemon Beach House. And she promptly punches a big hole in the wall, and of course, to pay off the damages, she gets a job and kind of gets adopted by the family that owns it. And it's sweet. It's a sweet, sweet show. It's a slice of life anime. It's a lot of fun. Very endearing. Aika is voiced by Hisako Kanemoto, who was Sailor Mercury in Sailor Moon Crystal. So that's cool. That's very cool. Rai Takanaka was voicing in this. She voiced Shizuru Azawa, and if her voice sounds kind of familiar in a big anime head, she was Saki in Steel Angel Karumi 2. So, yeah. Aika Musume. Check it out. Check out Squid Girl. It's a great anime. I like it a lot. I don't feel like it gets enough attention. Should be more popular than it is. Next question. What is one anime that's messed up you would recommend to somebody? And I thought about it and I'm like, well, I don't really know a whole lot of messed up ones that I can really recommend. But gonna have to go with 1987's Wicked City. You know? Fucking Wicked City, guys. It's got Yasaku Yara, who was the narrator in Godzilla vs. Megaguirus. A lot of Godzilla narrators in this tag, guys. I don't know, that's kind of weird. Also, it's got Toshiko Fujita, who was Cindy in Gogo 13, The Professional. And basically, the whole premise of Wicked City is there are these two government agents. They're assigned to protect a signatory to this peace treaty between the demon world and the human world. And there's radicalized demons trying to kill them, and there's a neat little twist at the end. And I recommend. It's got a lot of lewdness in it, but... Oh, actually, a lot of anime has a lot of lewdness in it, so I mean, I don't know if it's really messed up after all. But I'm gonna recommend it. Check it out. I recommend... Watch it, love it, like it, deal with it. Next question. Favorite anime crush? And guys, I gotta be honest. I really gotta be honest with you. You might think it's BS, but I don't have one. I mean, they're just... It's cool if you do. I mean, you do you. But for me, they're just cartoons. That's all I see is cartoons. I mean, I see characters I like, characters I admire, but I don't really see anybody I have a crush on. So, fortunately, big goose egg on that answer. Sorry, no, nothing controversial answer. I have no controversy. Next question. What is... I already did that question, of course. Next question is recommended anime you don't think anyone has really seen or heard of. And I gotta go, I never hear anyone talk about it, but 1994's Iria Zarum the Animation. This is directed by Tetsuru Amino, and it's basically a bounty hunter who is hunting monsters, and on her very first mission, her brother gets killed. That monster later, you know, resurfaces. She hunts it to seek revenge for her brother's death, and it's just a cool movie, and it's based off a live-action movie, which is a science fiction thriller known as Zarum, which is very good, and it's got a lot of cool practical effects. I can't recommend that enough. If you want to swing into the live-action zone for a little while, check that out. And there's also a sequel to it, Zarum 2. So check that out, too, if you like the first one. I think you will. And Iria was voiced by Aya Hisakawa, who was Sailor Mercury in Sailor Moon. That's another Sailor Moon friggin' coincidence. I don't know. But, hey, you got two Godzilla voices, you got two Sailor Moon voices. That's neat. Honorable mentions, guys, because there's so many animes, I gotta do an honorable mentions section. So I'm just going to mention it. You guys have already heard of most of these, but mention them anyway. Dragon Ball, Dragon Ball Z, Dragon Ball Super, Dragon Ball movies. Anything Dragon Ball, I recommend. It's a lot of fun. It's cool, you know. Saiyans, you know what I'm saying? Another recommendation, guys, Sailor Moon. Gonna recommend Sailor Moon up there. Also, I'm gonna recommend Steel Angel Kurumi. Almost chose that for one that doesn't get enough attention, but really felt the area, guys. Gotta do Area's Arum instead. Spice and Wolf, gonna recommend that. I'm gonna recommend Inuyasha. A lot of people seen Inuyasha. Gonna recommend Goku Midnight Eye, which that's cool. I don't know, that's fairly popular. You've probably seen that. And My Bride is a Mermaid, which I don't think very many people have seen either. But that's a great comedy. Basically, this kid almost drowned to death. He's rescued by a mermaid, and in doing so, he discovers her identity, which by Merlaw means they gotta get married, guys. And surprise, surprise, the twist of this is her family is a bunch of mobsters. And that just brings so much good comedy. So, yeah, that's it. That's my anime tag. And I want to thank you for watching. I was tagged in this video by my friend Marty over Trash Picture Show. He does a lot of good videos, figure reviews, movie reviews, panel discussions. Check this guy out. And if you liked my stuff, if you liked this, you might like my other things. So check me out. Maybe leave a like in the comments, or leave a comment, leave a like. If you're really enthused, consider subscribing. And if you thought it sucked, you hate it, you want me to stop, you need it, you just need this to end. Make the hurting stop. Give me a thumbs down. Tell me why. You know, put it out there. But again, if you really liked it, you followed it, you subscribed, you thumbs it up, consider following me on Twitter over at _Ethel_Cross_. I'm on there a lot. You can talk to me. Please talk to me. I'm lonely. I got no one to talk to. That's just me and the cat here. Do that, and thank you for watching. I have more tags to do, so I will see you all later. Adios. Actually, whoa, guys, hold on. Stop. You know what? I can't end this video like this. This is an anime tag. I should end this like an anime, man. You know what? What do I do? I know. Gotta do anime things. Let's do the bittersweet anime credits. Yeah, bittersweet anime credits.窓から見える星の空、ちりばめられたダイヤモンド、すぐ隣にゆけるならこの気持ちだって伝えたい。悲しみの